in this video, I will be baking some fudge brownies and just softly speaking with you once in a while. So not continually. And just telling you what I'm doing as I stir and mix everything together and bake these for you guys. So, we will be using this mix by Betty Crocker. It's a really great fudge brownie mix that I make all the time. Very simple. You just add eggs, water, and some oil. So I've got everything that we need here. And this is a custom video for Tiffany. Thank you so much, Tiffany. Yes, I am going to be doing some built-up tapping as we go. Let's go ahead and use this whisk to whisk up our eggs. This is the oil that we will be using. You can use any vegetable oil. I'm using mozzarella. And I've already poured it into our measuring cup, along with 3 tablespoons of water. I filled this and did 3 tablespoons. So let's together go ahead and pour this in to the egg mixture. Okay. And get that mixed together. So you can see that all the egg, oil, and water is mixed all together. This portion of the ball is like silicone, and this is plastic. So next, what we have to add in is our brownie mix. To show you what we did so far, we've got the 3 tablespoons of water, 1/2 cup of vegetable oil, and 2 eggs. So heat the oven. I'm not going to heat it while filming because otherwise you'll hear it, but I'll do that later. And then, but you usually do that right off the bat. And we are now just stirring all these items together, the brownie mix, water, oil and eggs. And we are going to get a pan in a moment and put it in there for you. But we're going to stir quite a bit for the sounds of this video. Some different sounds. This is more of a spatula. Typically that's about all that I would do, but because it's really for the video sounds, I'm going to keep mixing. Lumps out. I love these custom ideas that you guys come up with. The custom video ideas, so creative. Because this is such a great sound. Hearing someone bake. And I'm just simply doing a box mix because I'm living with other people in their home. and so I didn't want to have to grab all the ingredients, sugars and baking powders and baking sodas and etc. flour. So I did it all in one, but I will mix it slowly together. Meaning I did it all in one using a packet like this that includes all the ingredients you need. Sides of the bowl so you don't miss any of that yumminess. So, kind of midway through, you can see that portions are not mixed in yet. This is a silicone spatula. I really like using silicone in the kitchen, it's nice. It's really sturdy and I feel like it doesn't ever, like, with plastic I feel like pieces kind of start to melt off. You can see that most of it's mixed in now. So let's go ahead and keep adding to it. The bottom's all good too. It's getting thicker, which is good. Getting thicker, so the ball's moving a bit with the stirring. But it seems to be doing okay. It's got kind of a sticky bottom, just keeping it in place a bit. Because I'm holding the camera with the other hand. Oh, look at that. That looks so good. If you haven't tried these, they're really, really good. They're like a dollar. I usually get them for $1. Okay, let's add in a little bit more of our mix. Again, this includes the flour, sugar, and your baking soda, baking powder. Gooey gooey. Kind of like how the colors are mixing together like that. The powder's mixing in with the darker chocolate. Let's let it rest for a minute as we tap a bit. You see how the sides, we really have to use the spatula. The bowl has this kind of grip area here, which is helping. Slowly scrape down the sides and get it all mixed in together. Now, as I've said, if you're making this at home, it doesn't take this long. I want to give you nice sounds and visuals, so I'm taking my time mixing everything in. But it just takes a minute if you're doing it on your own at home. Mistaken. Typically, when you stir things together, it does say until well blended, but you typically don't want to overmix too. So in this case, I'm probably overmixing a bit, but that's fine because I want it to be for you guys. Look, it says you can stir in an ingredient for intense flavor. Look, you can put more chocolate, candy bars even. Looks like they've done some kind of Snickers. You can add dried cherries, cranberries, or coconut. Or even a salty crunch. They said half a cup of crushed mini pretzels or potato chips. And then this is what you do for your pan stuff. So we're going to do a 350, 13 by 9 inch pan, but 22 to 24 minutes. I'm going to try and find a pan like this. And I will show you as I do all the remaining steps as well. But yeah, you don't want to like super over blend either. One tip I have found personally is that if you refrigerate your brownies a bit before baking, I don't know, they just come out just that bit better. Do any of you guys bake? I bet a bunch of you do. Do any of you bake professionally? Some butter sounds. Mm. my gosh. Look at the way. Look at the way it came off us. That spatula. Look at that. The silicone and the oil together just really make it an easy clean up. It doesn't stick at all. Forgive me if you can hear some outside sounds. I needed to film this while all people were sleeping and are quiet, which is actually hard to find around these places here, because there are littles that wake up at all hours. They have a little cold, and so do I. No crying and no sounds was difficult to come by, so forgive me for the outside sounds that you can kind of hear, if you can. I don't know, hopefully you can't, but if you can, I'm sorry. Okay, let's go ahead and oil our pan now. Should be in like a 13 by 9 inch, but they didn't have that, so I'm going to use 3 pans instead of just 1. Okay, let's spray it in. Okay. We've got our 3 pans here. I am going to gently let the batter pour down into each pan. I want you to see it is now spreading really slowly. Can you see that movement just a bit? You can kind of see this portion spreading out. Spreading, spreading. You can see all of the spray. I did a little extra for sounds and all the different kind of bubbles forming. Okay. As I looked at the amount in here, I realized I don't think I'm going to use the other pans. I think I'm actually just going to make it a thicker brownie and keep it in the oven longer than they've asked. I've done it before and it still turned out great, so I'm going to do that because I feel that it might just be too much and too thin if I do 3 pans to equal the amount of service space they were asking for. So let's just add it all into one pan, but you guys still got some good spray sounds, so that's good. More spray sounds for the other pans. We've got most of it. There's still some, of course, on here, but that's okay. Okay, so it's all filled up. And actually, it's only going to probably about here, which surprises me. So it'll puff up pretty high when I bake it. So this is what it looks like, all baked up. I mean, excuse me, all poured into the pan. It's not baked yet. All poured in. So it says that you can also do 9x9. So I'm going to do this version here. I kind of wanted to spread it because I like usually the thickness when it's in a pan this size, but no problem. We're going to make it thicker and do this 36 to 38 or 350 degrees. I wanted to show you the finished product. I took a piece out for you to see. It's really, really good. It's really chewy and it's really soft. And so I highly recommend that kind of brownie. Thank you again, Tiffany, for this idea. Sweet to eat as well. I'm sorry to show you a brownie that you can't eat, but I kind of want you to be able to see the crevices and such. See how on the top it's like kind of like crunchy on top, but like really soft on the inside and chewy. So I usually eat my brownies with a bit of ice cream. Well, a lot of ice cream, not a bit. Mates and have them enjoy as well. I will say I used a convection oven and it does cook much faster than a normal oven setting. So I kind of like smelt that it was done before the timer went off. If you're doing convection oven, I recommend doing it for less time, keeping it for less time than the instructions say.